behind him, here's how the Astros will line it up on defense. Gerard Dyson stands in for the first time. Now here's the pitch. 1-2 pitch is swung on and lifted in the air out to center field. Springer is underneath this one. One gone.
Yeah, an easy fly ball there to start the ball game. One of the big keys for him in this one is going to be keeping that leadoff man off base. He's off to a good start here.
Gene Segura steps into the box. Now here's the pitch. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw gets him, two down.
And you know, pitching's a lot more than just velocity. This guy, he's living proof. If you hit your spot, change speeds, you can get guys out with an 87, 88 mile an hour fastball, and he did it right there.
The second baseman, Robinson Cano, gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back. Jammed him there as this is rolled out to short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Mariners are down in order. And now the Astros will go to work for the first time. No score. Starting lineup for the Astros looks like this. And they'll go to work against no small task indeed. The 2010 American League Cy Young Award winner, King Felix, right-hander Felix Hernandez. And the Mariners defensively would look like this behind him. George Springer will get his first cuts here. Hernandez readies the 1-1. Ooh, jumped the gun a bit on that swing, and he's down 1-2. You have to figure that sinker's going to be an important pitch for him here this afternoon.
No question about it. Obviously, it's his ground ball pitch, so if you're a hitter, you're going to need to make him bring that pitch up a bit.
Here's a bouncing ball now headed for the shortstop, Segura. And reined in, one away.
Batting second, third baseman, Alex Brennan.
Alex Brennan digs in here for his first appearance. Smack the opposite way now, and this should give him at least two bases. Head down through first. He's heading for two. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Well, this is the kind of at-bat that's going to give him a lot of confidence going forward. There's no doubt that he can hit left-handed pitching. He's proven that throughout his time in the minor leagues. Question is, though, can he be productive against right-handers? That's an encouraging sign there.
Oh. In now, Jose Altuve. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. Throw beats him by a half a step. He almost beat that out.
Batting fourth, the shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Carlos Correa, the hitter now with a chance to pick up that runner from second with two away. And a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball, one and two now. Two out here and a runner at second. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying the deep right. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. One left for Houston. We've played an inning. No score. Nelson Cruz makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. That's a strike in the rule book, but most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Come on, let's do it.
Strike. Now a high bouncer toward the hole. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Well, and that's exactly what you want to do right there. Get yourself another ground ball, and that's a good way to start the second as he gets the easy ground out.
Kyle Seager digs in, ready for his first plate appearance. No score here as we play inning number two. And he misses, 2-1.
I got 2-1 the count.
He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo home run here for Kyle Seager as the Mariners take a 1-0 lead.
It goes without saying, but this is the one guy in the lineup that you just cannot let beat you, or even just hurt you for that matter. Still, though, they fall behind him and they give him something on the inside part of the plate that he can turn on. That's just a recipe for disaster.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3-2. And look out as this bat shatters on impact. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Really?
Payoff pitch one more time. Out in front as this is drilled into left field, that's a base hit.
Oh, and this ball center cut right here. Got it right on the barrel. He just drills it into left field for a one-out single.
Number 20 steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
He just about went around. He was lucky to put on the brakes when he did.
I
Two and two. Runners on first with one down. And that's lifted the other way out to left. Aoki is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Leonis Martin set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on one and two. You started in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. Turned out to be a good take.
He's set. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. Mariners get one on this swing by Kyle Seager. On to the bottom of inning number two. It's 1-0 Seattle. Carlos Beltran strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning. Man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second.
And now on the mound after the leadoff walk, you put yourself in a situation where you're going to give these guys a good chance to get that run right back. I mean, here's where he'll need to try to get the next guy to hit something on the ground.
Brian McCann gets his first shot here with a man on following the leadoff walk. From the belt, kicks and deals. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
And this has been the big concern with this guy over the last couple seasons. He's prone to getting hurt by the base on balls. Already that's two walks here in the early going. And that's something that he's going to need to get a handle on pretty quick.
Josh Reddick steps in now. First and second here with nobody out. Reaches for one and slaps it down the line at third. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. Three and two. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Swinging a ground ball towards the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit. The throw home. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. Yu Gurriel is ready for his first AB here in this one. A 1-2 pitch from Felix. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Well, that's just your classic 0-2 changeup right there. And what he's trying to do there is to get that hitter's aggressiveness to work against him. And he just goes fishing in the dirt for a bad pitch and an easy punch out.
Into the box now, Nori Aoki. And he'll just lay this one in there, 3-1.
That might take the anxiety away for the moment. But he's going to need a couple more here to prove to himself that he's not losing it.
And this is heading out toward left field, but this is going to get fouled up into the crowd. Come set, now the pitch. Hit hard toward the right side. But this is speared by the first baseman.
Boy, and how they get out of this one with only one out on this play is a mystery. This probably should have been much more than that, but they can't wind up making the play.
Oh. Stepping in now, George Springer. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. Fastball here.
I think it has to be. You're licking your chops if you're the hitter. 3-1, you can't walk the bases loaded. Bail and whale.
He's ready. Now the pitch. And there's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. He'll try it again, 3-2. And a big strikeout there as they'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. Astros forced to settle for only the one run. We'll go now to the top of the third, all tied at 1-1. Ben Gamble steps in here to start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow. Here's the pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Now batting, left fielder, Jared Dyson.
Jared Dyson will get a second crack at it here. He flied out to lead off the ball game. Now the pitch. And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. The pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Gene Segura is on deck. And this is lifted the other way to left center. There to play it is Springer, and that's out number two.
Yeah, that's just a good pitch right there. That's a two-seam fastball working its way back inside, and he's probably fortunate he didn't break his bat. He winds up getting this one right down there on the label, and he's retired.
Into the box, Gene Segura. Down low, two balls and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. And this is popped high in the air toward the left side. Correa is camped under this one as he tucks this one away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. Home half of the third coming up, tied at one. Alex Brennan digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three. Down the line in right and in amongst the fans. The next 3-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Now a ball line foul up and over the Astro dugout. And we'll see another pitch here as this ball's chopped foul at home plate. A payoff pitch one more time. That softly hit to right. Will that get down? No, it'll be taken in by the second baseman, covering some ground out there as he makes the play.
I think another look here will show that this should have been ball four. And those are the little things that start to pile up if you're not careful. You've got to have a better understanding of the strike zone.
Standing in now, Jose Altuve. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. And here's a ball hit in the air. Under it now is Segura, and he's got it. Two away now.
Whatever he's doing out there, it's working out for him. That's back-to-back pop-ups here to start the inning, and he's just making it look easy.
Carlos Correa is at the plate now, flied out in his first at-bat. The 1-2 pitch from Felix. Two and two now with two away and the base is empty. Two out, nobody on. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first and the side is retired. So a strong inning there for Felix Hernandez. And it remains a one-all tie. Robinson Cano is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth. Now the pitch. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, he tried to climb the ladder on him there, but it was easy to lay off that pitch because it was so far out of the zone that it wasn't really tempting.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Nelson Cruz will stand in. He took home a Silver Slugger Award for American League outfielders a year ago. Come set, now the pitch. And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
Has a look, now the pitch. Swing, hard hit ball to second. The second for one. On to first, the double play.
Well, if you want to go by the numbers, somewhere around 37% of leadoff walks come around a score. Now, EK, I know you didn't know that, but that won't be an issue here as he bounces right back and he gets himself the double play.
Into the box now, Kyle Seager. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. None left for Seattle. On to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Carlos Beltran is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. And now a pitch on the way. Hit high but foul as that'll get in amongst the fans. Oh, high. Deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. A solo shot here for Carlos Beltran. And the Astros take the lead. It's 2-1.
And about the only silver lining to this one from a defensive standpoint is the fact that it came with the bases empty leading off an inning. So you can survive it when this guy's hitting just solo shots. It's when he's doing his damage with two or three guys on base that things can really get out of hand in a hurry.
Stepping in now, Brian McCann. Swing and a liner. Another try at 2-2. And that is swung on and missed as McCann is retired for the first out.
Quite a challenge pitch here on 2-2. He decides to take him up in the zone, and I bet he was looking for something down at the knees because he swung right underneath him.
In now, Josh Reddick. 3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. And this is a strike three called. Oh, caught a break there. Two away.
Well, this is how you bounce back from giving up a home run. Back-to-back strikeouts. As a pitcher, you've got to have a short memory out there. He looks like he's come back from that one in pretty good shape.
Standing in now, Yu Gurriel. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Now here's the pitch. Here's a bouncing ball now headed for the shortstop, Segura. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Astros get a run here courtesy of the solo homer. We're through four. 2-1 Houston. Mike Zunino heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. This one's chopped foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Swing and a ball hit hard to third. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
You want to talk about getting the bat head out front? Well, he just rips this ball. But look at that play down at third base. This is just stick your glove out and hope that it finds the webbing. And this one did as he gets up and throws him out.
Into the box now, number 20. Here's a ball swung on and lofted in the air out toward right center. There to take it is Reddick, and there are two gone now.
Center fielder number 12, Leonis Martin.
Leonis Martin comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time. Bases are empty here with two men out. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
Good swing there, but this is fouled off to the right side. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Ah, and they're able to keep the inning alive as you check out the numbers on his performance so far. That's just the third hit he's allowed to this point. He's been pretty much in control the whole way.
Ben Gamel stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
From the belt, the pitch, and a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. And he'll step off and fire to the bag. And the runner back. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
And now, 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Pause, now the pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Oh, you know he wanted that one. Now the inning will continue, and the guy moves up into scoring position here.
Jerod Dyson digs in, and we'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in the fifth. Two down, runners at first and second. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short. On to first, and the throw goes right by him. And they've come back to tie it up as it's now a 2-2 ball game.
Well, he tries to rush this thing and make an off-balance throw to first. But when you do that, you don't always know where the ball's going, and this will wind up a throwing error.
The box, Gene Segura. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Swing and a hard hit grounder down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Runners at second and third with two gone. And a big strikeout there as they'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't capitalize any further. Mariners forced to settle for one. Home half of the fifth coming up, and we are tied 2-2. Nori Aoki comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth. Hernandez readies the 1-1. Here's Cano now at second. And he's set down, one away.
Now batting, center fielder, George Springer.
George Springer will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Hernandez will get ready to deliver pitch number 75 so far. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. And he'll get in there safely.
Hard hit ball right here, right down the line. And you be the judge. Is this fair or is it foul? That's awfully close. It looked like it indeed hopped right over the bag, and that's all it's got to do. He's going to wind up at second base here with two bases.
Stepping in now, Alex Brennan. And this is fouled at the plate.
Oh,
little dribbler up the line to first. But this is foul. Here's another 1-2. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. But one thing he's shown so far, he's not afraid to work inside.
Yeah, with that base open right now, he shouldn't have to be afraid. If you do hit him, big deal. Get the next guy.
Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. And it's a foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. Stays alive here as this is fouled off to the right. Another 2-2 offering. Hit hard on the ground to short. In time to first, and there are two away.
Well, that's a nice job right there to readjust to that curveball. I don't know if he was sitting on it or what, but he certainly hit it hard. Unfortunately for him, right at someone.
Jose Altuve will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. He's ready now. The pitch. Swing and a liner back through the box. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And he will beat the tag at the plate as he scores to make it a 3-2 game.
Now you can pretty clearly see he's starting to make some mistakes in location, and they're jumping on him. Here, this is out over the plate. And he doesn't miss it. Lines it for an RBI single.
And double-barreled action now in the Mariner bullpen as both the left-hander and the right-hander start to throw. Standing in now, Carlos Correa. Changeup. Good pitch there. 1-2. Check by Hernandez. The pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Astros plate one on a couple of hits. We're through five here at the ballpark. It's the Astros 3 and the Mariners 2. Robinson Cano will get things going here in the Mariner sixth as he'll step in to lead off the inning. Lays off that time and it's 1-2. Swing and a miss by Cano as he set down on strikes, and there's one away.
Just overmatched there. It's a 1-2 fastball. This is right by him. Absolutely no contact.
Now some action out in the Houston bullpen as it appears both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Into the box now, Nelson Cruz. Changed up on him here, and this is grounded to short. On to first, and there are two down. Kyle Seager will come in now with two away, and to this point at least, so much for having the 3-4-5 guys get the rally started.
Yeah, it's been an important inning for that man out there on the mound. He's held his ground, and he may get through the teeth of this lineup, still holding on to that lead.
Oh. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Mariners are down in order. They trail 3-2. Carlos Beltran will lead things off here for Houston as they look to get things started in this sixth inning. One one now to Beltran, and that swung on and fouled straight back. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. And a swing and a miss that time by Beltran, and he's set down on strikes for the first out.
And this is why, as a hitter, working the count in your favor is so important. I mean, here, this is probably a ball, but you can't risk taking this pitch on 1-2 and hope that you get the benefit of the umpire's call. You pretty much have to swing at it, even though you probably wouldn't have been able to do much with it in the first place.
In now, Brian McCann. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Up next for the Astros, right fielder,
Josh Reddick will stand in now. He singled and struck out in two trips. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes.
Come on, Houston.
The 1-2 pitch from Felix.
Nope.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Yeah, he's still sticking with that fastball, but you start to get the sense that it's flattening out just a little bit. That could be a warning sign.
Bounty goes down and lines this one into left field, a base hit. Here comes the Seattle skipper on his way to the mound. And that will be all we see this afternoon of the Cy Young Award winner, Felix Hernandez. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision.
Nick Vincent
will come on and try to get out of this mess here as there are two on with only one away. Nick Vincent. Uriel will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. He's set, now the pitch. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. And now on 3-2, do you put any thought into sending the runners here with one away? Ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. It's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Stepping in now, Nori Aoki. Nipped the corner, 2-2.
Now with two strikes, he can put the ground ball on the back burner and really go after the strikeout here.
3-2 is our score here in inning number six. This is hit sharply to the left side. And he has delivered one of the biggest at-bats of the afternoon as he cashes in with a base hit. The tag, and he is out.
George Springer.
Strides in now, and we'll see if he can come through with two on and two out here in the sixth. Two men are on with two men out. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full, 3-2. In danger now of a second walk out of the bullpen.
Not exactly providing relief. He's got to find it here somehow.
And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball four.
Well, we knew he had to work carefully with the runner in scoring position, but I don't think a walk was what he had in mind. It's going to make things just a little trickier now with the bases loaded.
Alex Brennan steps into the box here in one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far. Bases juiced now with two away. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconuts.
He did not like that one bit. Now, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff. Don't do it around the dome.
From the stretch. Foul back. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Astros plate one on a couple of hits. Seventh inning coming up. The Astros lead it 4-2. Back here at Minute Maid Park in Houston. It's on to the seventh now with the Astros on top in this one. And as the final warm-up tosses are thrown, let's get a look at our game summary through six innings. Mike Zunino is set to get us started for the late innings of this one. Able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And this is fouled back and out of play. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Yeah, on a slow chopper like that, that is the third baseman's ball if he can get to it. He's got the momentum going the right way towards first base, so he'll just cut right in front of the shortstop and make that play to first.
Into the box, number 20. And that's outside. He lost him ball four.
And now, the further he goes in this one, the less precise he's going to be with his location. You can see it up on the screen. He's up over 90 pitches here, so he's starting to get tired and running out of gas out there.
Leonis Martin will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. Had him off balance a bit as this is skied into short left center. There to take it is Aoki, and there are two away now.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
Ben Gamel stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. Look into McCann, the 1-1. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. Now a half swing here on the pitch inside, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the home plate umpire. Strike two. He waits. Now the pitch. Hit hard to the right side, but foul, so we'll see if he can straighten that out. Comes set, now the pitch. And it gets under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central. And Springer will tuck this one in to retire the side. One left for Seattle. They trail it here 4-2.
Your attention, please.
New pitcher coming on now as they'll hand it off to Casey Fien here. Jose Altuve will dig in again. He singled home a run his last time. Now a swing and a ball lofted down the right field line and fairly deep. Gamble back and he reaches up to put it away for a long out number one.
And right here you've got the right fielder shading just a bit towards the alley. And I thought he'd have too far to go to get this ball, but he does close quickly out there, and he makes the play near the line.
Standing in now, Carlos Correa.
I got the count, 2-2.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Waiting in the on-deck circle, there's Carlos Beltran. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Up next for the Astros,
Carlos Beltran gets another shot. And if you remember, he hit a round tripper back in the fourth. Four runs, seven hits, one error so far for the Astros. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
And when he's missing, he's not missing by much. That one might have been just a hair low, but as a hitter on 3-1, you have the luxury of making a pitcher bring something up.
Brian McCann digs in. He reached on a walk his last time up and later came around to score. From the belt, kicks and deals. Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Runners are at first and second with one away. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. The next 3-2. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3-2. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
Huh. That strike zone has opened up a little bit here in the late going. That's a tough pill to swallow in a spot like this, but nothing you can do about it now.
Josh Reddick gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven. Two down, runners at first and second. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
Yeah, you can't afford to be selective now. You've got to expand that zone. Try and put something in play.
Nero!
Come set, now the pitch. Fouled straight back. He'll try again, 1-2. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Two men are on with two men out. And this one's in the dirt. But fortunately here, no advance. He's set, now the pitch. Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats. And he's just fighting to stay alive here, still 2-2. He's ready, now the pitch. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More to come from Houston after this. Gerard Dyson will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And the pitch. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. To 2-2 now. Now here it comes. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. With that, we'll give you a look at our starter comparison for the two starting pitchers in the game. And the column to look at is the one on the right side of your screen. Not too many hits to go around at this point in the ballgame. Gene Segura will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ballgame.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
Let's go, Astros!
Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. To two balls and two strikes now. And he stays alive as this is grounded foul. Slider, strike three called, and that's a pitcher's pitch right there. Two gone. Astros on top in front of the home crowd here at Minute Maid Park as you get a look at the line score to this point here in the eighth inning. Robinson Cano will stand in as they're quickly down to their final four outs tonight. Here's the 1-1 now to Cano. And a half swing here, but he pretty clearly went around, and it's 1-2 now. Two runs, four hits, and no errors in the game for the Mariners to this point. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. Now the pitch. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. Still down by a count of 4-2. Ryan Cook is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. Ryan Cook. Yu Gurriel stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. The pitch. And this is hit well towards the hole. And that's a base hit, so a chance for some important insurance here to kick off the bottom of the eighth. Nori Aoki gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. He's ready now. The pitch. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Off-speed pitch, good for strike two.
And after you move a guy off the plate and you know he's all worked up, that's a perfect time to drop a curveball or a changeup on him. Great pitch call right there.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Well, you never know. This might have been the lesser of two evils right here. If you take this pitch, you know it's strike three. If you swing, you might bounce into a double play ball. So the best he could have done was maybe fouled that thing off, but instead, he comes up empty.
Into the box now, George Springer. Oh, on the ground to short. Could this be two? Back to first, and a great stretch there may be the difference. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Nothing doing there for Houston, but they still lead this one 4-2. Ken Giles is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Nelson Cruz will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-for-3 thus far. A little bit outside. 2-1.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
Set up away with the fastball, but it misses. 3-1.
And down by two, you better believe they'll take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner.
And a full count now, 3-2.
And here's where you don't need to be an RBI guy. Don't need to be a home run guy. You have to be a leadoff guy. Just get on base somehow to give that tying run on deck a shot.
Here it comes. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. This pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
When you talk about giving these guys a shot, now you've got a real dangerous guy waiting in that on deck circle. All of a sudden, he's the tying run.
Kyle Seager will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. A runner at first with no outs here. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. Gone! And we are tied here in the ninth. Two-run home run off the bat of Kyle Seager. His second home run of the game, as that'll pull him even at four apiece.
Boy, I want you to check out the location of where this pitch is in the strike zone. It's up and it's right down the middle. I mean... maybe get away with that to a 220 hitting backup catcher, but not to a guy like this.
In now, Mike Zunino. And this is fouled back and out of play. Base is empty here with nobody out. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Now he extends nicely, and this ball's driven to right field and deep. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Ball called strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, after you've just given up a home run to tie the ball game, you can't afford to have a letdown out there. And he made sure he didn't. He came back with an important strikeout. He got the next guy.
Stepping in now, number 20. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground.
He's out.
Throw on to first, two gone. Leonis Martin will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now here's the pitch. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, he just hasn't been able to find any kind of groove out there. Hasn't been able to hit his spots. And now at 3-1, he's put him in yet another great hitting camp.
And that one is a cold strike as he's rebounded to run at full now, 3-2. And he strikes him out on a good pitch, so one run can win it as we head to the bottom of the inning. Mariners get a couple in the inning on the two-run home run. We'll go to the bottom of the ninth, and we are tied 4-4. Alex Brennan, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And now pitch on the way. Good wood on it there, but foul, so they'll do it again. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
And this is a two-seam fastball with a little bit of life to it. They'll often run east to west or vice versa, depending on the pitcher's handedness. He just had no answer for this one.
Standing in now, Jose Altuve. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. Bases are empty, one man out. Chopper foul. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
This is exactly what he needed after his guys came back to tie the ball game. He's only one out away from a shutdown inning.
Carlos Correa stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here, with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Here's the pitch. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Two out, nobody on. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw in time, and the side is retired. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means free baseball here this afternoon. 10th inning coming up, and we are tied 4-4. Tony Sipp will come on now as he'll take over to start the extra frame. Ben Gamel will come on now to start things out in the 10th, and you have to figure the momentum is squarely on their side after the manner in which that 9th inning went down.
Yeah, just a great comeback to tie the game in the top of the 9th, followed by putting up a 0 in the bottom half. This is a ball club that just won't quit out there, and they're going to keep fighting until the last out.
And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Three and one. Three and two. Off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, and here in extra innings, you just need one little spark, something that can get you going. You know, we've seen a leadoff walk to be the difference in a ball game more times than once, so they need to take advantage of this.
Gerard Dyson digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. And he'll indeed square on 3-1 as he gets this one down. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Well, this is a nice job here of giving himself up. You see him square and put this ball down over toward the right side of the infield, and that's just where you want it to be. They do put the tag on him, but hey, he gets the job done.
Into the box, Gene Segura. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Gurriel is over and he tucks it away for the second out.
A good hitter's count there on 3-1. And with the runner in scoring position, he's thinking he's going to get something good. He winds up popping this one straight up. That's a costly out.
Robinson Cano digs in, looking to send something into the outfield that gives that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. And he strikes him out here for out number three, so after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. Mariners leave one. Score remains tied at 4. Carlos Beltran gets another shot, and if you remember, he hit a round tripper back in the fourth. One now to Beltran, and this is going to be a foul ball. And oh, look out as he has to hop out of the way of the fastball there.
I'll say this, he wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
And a fastball runs in a bit too close for comfort that time. Waiting next is Brian McCann. Hit toward the hole, through. It's a base hit, and the winning run is on to start the inning.
You're going to see the location of this pitch on ShowTrack. It's actually in a great spot. Couple inches off that inside corner. Normally, you think all a guy could do is chop that and foul it, but he gets those hands through very quickly and he just yanks it.
Now time is called and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. In now, Brian McCann inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. A look at the hit totals there into extra innings. Possible winning run aboard here, nobody out. Runner's going. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Ready with another two-strike offering. In front of a changeup there as this is chopped foul at home plate. Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats. And he's just fighting to stay alive here, still 2-2. Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game.
And he was really late on this one. I mean, really late. You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Into the box now, Josh Reddick.
Nope, that's a ball.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. For the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be two? Back to first. It's a double play, and we've got more baseball coming our way as the inning is over. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. 10 innings in the books, on to the 11th, still tied. Nelson Cruz comes to the plate as the leadoff man here in the 11th inning. And there's ball two now. Now here it comes. Now a ball crushed high in the air, deep to left, way back there, and that one is long gone. A solo home run from Nelson Cruz as they will take the lead here. It's now a 5-4 ball game.
Oh, well, this is how you start an extra inning off right. Now, he wants to go home, too, so he drops a barrel on that one, and now these guys will need to see if this will stand up.
Kyle Seager will stride in one more time, looking for home run number 3 in the ballgame as we flash you back here to his second home run. As you see what got us to where we are now, a big ninth inning shot that helped propel us into extra innings. Look into McCann, the 1-1. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. Pitch on the way. Fouled back. No outs, nobody on. Swing and a miss there on a late-breaking slider as he sat down on strikes for the second time this afternoon.
Well, I'm sure he'll say the damage is already done after serving up the lead, but, you know, that's good fortitude to come back with a punch-out, and he needed that.
Stepping in now, Mike Zunino. And this is drifting foul back into the stands. The next 0-2, and he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2. Here's one hit towards the hole. Throw in time at first for out number 2.
Now back, number 20.
Number 20 stands in. Now the pitch. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. And he gets a piece there and chops it foul at home plate as the count moves to 2-2 now. And he strikes him out here for out number 3, but the damage has been done as now they'll need some extra inning heroics to pull this one out. So just the one hit in the inning, but it's a home run that pushes him out in front. One last shot here as we go to the bottom of the 11th now. It's the M's 5 and the Astros 4. Edwin Diaz will come on now, and they've saved him for the 11th as he'll try and take this one home. Yu Gurriel will come forward now, trying to at least get on base with his guys down to run here in extra innings.
Yeah, I don't think you really need to be swinging for the fences just yet. You just need to find a way to get some guys on base and get that conveyor belt rolling.
And a slider misses here. 2 balls and a strike.
But when you start that pitch off the edge, well, most guys know well enough to lay off. You've got to start it on the edge if you want them to chase.
Caught him pretty good there as it ricochets toward the third baseline. And the recovery's a quick one as he gets his man at first. Good composure that time to record the first out of the inning. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Nori Aoki, ready to try again. Struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. The pitch. And that misses. 2-1. Anderson's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
That's a good at-bat there. And sometimes in extra innings, guys start to chase because they're getting tired and frustrated, and they're looking for one big hit. That's not the case here.
George Springer comes to the plate now with the tying run at first, so he'll be looking to drive a ball into the gap here. 1-2 as he chases the slider.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
That is a big time to come up with a strikeout in a tight game like this. You still got that tying run over there at first, but the two away now, you don't necessarily need a ground ball to get you out of this.
Alex Brennan digs in, and he'll try to improve on a 1-for-5 effort thus far. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now.
This is a good fastball spot for him now, and keep in mind, he's got a big hole on that right side of the infield.
Quick check on that tying run at first. And a dive, but he's back in there. He's set, now the pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. On to first, and that'll be a bitter pill to swallow for this home crowd as the ball game is over.
Well, maybe it took them a couple more innings than they had hoped, but a win's a win, and they get a good one here on the road in 11 innings.
Time for one last check of the line score in this extra innings victory. An entertaining game all in all, so if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he connected on a couple of long home runs, really put his guys on his back and carried them to the victory.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com.